Hi, I'm Mike Brangiaforte. Welcome to WAS Real Rock TV. We are backstage or in the dungeon of the New Odd in Worcester. Look at this place. It's the New Odd, too. I wonder what part they updated. It's not really looking too new. But we're going to interview the guys from Korn as they are playing here tonight. We are back here with the coughing members of Korn. The rhythm section, actually. We have Fieldy.
Yeah.
And we have David. I'm very excited, David. He actually just woke up a little while ago. Thanks for coming down. I appreciate it. So you guys are touring on your second album, and the first one did very well. Well, anyway, on to the second album.
The first album, I know, I'm sure everybody grills you guys about the whole topic of what the songs are about and the fact that the upbringing and problems with, you know, being abused and all that kind of stuff. Is the second album the same type of thing, same type of topics, or what's going on with that?
It's different. It's still about, like, bottled up tension, lyrically, bottled up aggression, that kind of thing. It's kind of in the same, different songs, of course, but it's kind of the same topics.
Well, it's kind of weird because, I mean, all the songs are pretty aggressive vocally and musically, yet you guys don't really come across as violent guys. Pretty calm, nice guys. Or do you guys, it's a totally different situation when you get on stage, huh?
We haven't made a video for those video channels. You know what I'm talking about.
Right.
Because we're not going to waste our money right now on that. So we put out a 45-minute length home video of footage from us recording the first album at Indigo Ranch Studios, and then us recording the second album, and just everybody hanging out, drinking beer together, just being real. So it's pretty cool for real fans, because they get to see us outside of being on stage as people. That should be coming out in stores pretty soon.
Excellent.
I think it's a little more hardcore out here. I mean, fans are a little crazier. You know, I don't want to really dog on the West Coast, but I guess the West Coast people like to hold a beer in their hand so that they can't really jump around as much, you know. Got to get them on their feet. West Coast tends.
Craziest ever, huh?
It'd be interesting to say because we're all from the West Coast. But I don't know, like, in, you know, you hit the East Coast anywhere around here, it's like they're hopping, you know, when you play. The West Coast is doing some 1980 mosh pit, you know. It's getting a little better, though. I don't know. I'm trying to help these guys out in the West Coast. Let's get with it.
Now, what's going on? I hear you guys are going to be opening up for Metallica at the beginning of 97. Where is that tour going to take you?
West Coast. And what does a Metallica crowd do? Mosh pit.
Oh boy!
No stopping that, because that's Metallica. You know, Metallica is—you can't even—you can't even fade that.
Are you excited? Are you fans of Metallica? Are you a fan of Metallica?
Yeah. Everybody in the band probably has almost all their records.
When you were growing up, what guys did you guys listen to Metallica? I mean, did you guys say that?
I got into them at Master of Puppets. I didn't get into Ride of Lightning, but I found out about it later. But since Master of Puppets, yeah.
It must be a pretty cool thing being asked to open up for Metallica. That's got to be pretty cool.
It's a cool thing, not almost. It's good.
Almost.
It's good. Hi, this is David.
And this is Fieldy.
We're from Korn.
Korn Dogs.
And you're watching Real Rock Television.
Gotta go.